morning, my creative friends. I decided that a little Monday morning poetry and tangling would be just the thing to start my day. I might have to pause in the middle to go open the door for someone, for our housekeeper this morning. But I wanted to take some time to just pause and get my week going. Time seems limited and busy and full, and showing up here in this quiet space with poems and Zentangle patterns helps my day to start in that little bit of a calmer space. And I found this lovely and very appropriate poem called October by Mary Oliver from her book Devotions. All month long, I am tangling different patterns and reading different poems. This is a fat book, and I'm just sort of randomly flipping through every day to find, I should dog-ear some of these pages, to find new poems to read and to share. So welcome to Painting in Your PJs with Dr. Minette Riordan. That's me. This channel is all about art as creative practice and creative process, and how can we use art to not just amplify our creativity or to get more practice, but to really use art as a way of sort of self-development and personal growth. And poetry and Zentangle are two practices that serve that mindful self-awareness for me. So here's October from Mary Oliver. There's this shape, black as the entrance to a cave. A longing wells up in its throat like a blossom as it breathes slowly. What does the world mean to you if you can't trust it to go on shining when you're not there? And there's a tree, long fallen. Once the bees flew to it like a procession of messengers and filled it with honey. I said to the chickadee, singing his heart out in the green pine tree, little dazzler, little song, little mouthful. The shape climbs up out of the curled grass. It grunts into view. There is no measure for the confidence at the bottom of its eyes. There is no telling the suppleness of its shoulders as it turns and yawns. Near the fallen tree, something, a leaf snapped loose from the branch and fluttering down, tries to pull me into its trap of attention. It pulls me into its trap of attention. And when I turn again, the bear is gone. Look, hasn't my body already felt like the body of a flower? Look, I want to love this world as though it's the last chance I'm ever going to get to be alive and know it. Sometimes in late summer, I won't touch anything. Not the flowers, not the blackberries brimming in the thickets. I won't drink from the pond. I won't name the birds or the trees. I won't whisper my own name. One morning, the fox came down the hill, glittering and confident, and didn't see me, and I thought, so this is the world. I'm not in it. It is beautiful. Mary Oliver's poem, October. And I'm loving this one, and maybe tangles are going to grow over this poem throughout this week. So the two I want to show you today are both botanical themed poems, and they both even start in kind of a simple way, and I'm kind of enjoying the sort of floral aspects of them. The first one is called SCARA by Midori FURUHASHI. Hopefully I'm saying her name right. And I'm going to draw this one here on this page. Let's see. Trying to see my step outs and see you guys too, so let me zoom in a little bit here. And I'm going to start with a little bitty orb, and then I'm going to draw six orbs around that center orb. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, I didn't get them spread out quite like I liked, but you know, first effort, best effort. And then using our S curve, we're going to go from the top left of one orb down to the center and a long, loose turn, and we're going to do that all the way around. So from the top left, that lovely S-curve, going all the way around. I attempted to squeeze one in there where I didn't get those out, but I'm going to go ahead and follow the instructions of the pattern this first time through. I want to show you the step outs and then we'll figure out where to go from here. And now inside of each of these lines, I'm going to draw another little orb in another loose random circle. And then I'm going to go from the underside of that orb all the way around to that next orb in more of a backward C shape. So underneath and around. And around. And underneath and around, wrapping all the way around that orb. You can see they're not all coming out exactly the same shape or size. That's totally fine. Turning my page as I need to. Turn that back around where we can see it again. And then I'm going to come on the inside of that orb. So from the right side. So this one I went to the wrong side. So we'll just have that one be a little bit different shape there. Next time we'll get it better. So from the inside. So we have these funny little petal shapes. And that is an attempt at drawing SCARA. And then what I love about this pattern is there's endless opportunities for embellishments, for shading. And again, it feels like these are gonna get, I'm thinking I just wanna have that one go that way and we're just gonna make it work. Endless opportunities for embellishment with the pattern SCARA here. So let's draw one more of those and then we'll move on to our second pattern. So again, I'm going to come in and I'm going to put this one maybe a little bit smaller, but I want to tuck it in close to that one. I got my circle a little more round. So top left to the bottom right, turning our page as needed, top left, around and under with that loose S-curve. Have you noticed that Zentangle patterns are all drawn using a few very simple shapes. And then I'm going to come under and around in almost that crescent moon shape. We're just repeating a series of lines and shapes over and over again. And it's the simplicity and the rhythm of repetition that creates that lovely mindful self-awareness. And I'll be live here tomorrow morning for my regular time at 7 a.m. Mountain Time on Tuesday and Thursday this week and Wednesday evening at 5 p.m. Mountain. The schedule is in the description of the videos if you want to come and join me live at any time. So that is our pattern SCARA. So sweet. And I really love this next one as well. Another botanical pattern. So let me find the step outs. This one's called WALNUTZ. It was inspired by, so it's by ILDICA Boyd, and it was inspired by the inside shape of a walnut. So we're going to start this one with a star shape. So we're going to, I'm looking at the step outs here. So we're going to have kind of a circle of five dots this time. And we're going to use those dots to help us draw a star. If you're comfortable drawing stars, you could just skip this step. But it's just connect the dots. And then we're going to, with a lovely little scooped petal shape, create our flower here. And I only have a few minutes to play this morning, so I wanted to be able to come in and share these patterns with you. And so this is that inside of that walnut, and it's kind of a little heart-shaped with a little bit of a bigger dip in the center than we would normally draw with a heart. Again, always turning my page to make it easier to draw. And again, I think there's, you know, a lot we could do in terms of embellishments with this one. When I think about all the nooks and crannies and crevices of a walnut, they're so pretty when you open them up. Many, many fun ways that we can begin to embellish all of these patterns. And I'm going to want to come back and add more of these on the page, maybe add some other patterns. So come back and join me live tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. Mountain Time for more poems and patterns here on Inktober Tangles all month long on Painting in Your PJs Live with Minette. So again, we have SCARA and WALNUTZ as our two patterns to start loving up and reading a few different times this lovely poem, October, by Mary Oliver. Thanks so much. I hope you have an amazing day. I know I feel a little bit calmer with just a few minutes of poems and Zentangle. Have a great day, my friends. Bye-bye.